Let's discuss more about the Bayesian detection rate. We can use the Bayes theorem to expand this, and we got this formula. Here, PI is the prior probability of attacks, meaning this is the probability of intrusion evidence in the data. An intuitive example is that, on a typical day, what's the percentage of packets that contain intrusion activities in our network? There's an interesting phenomenon about Bayesian detection rate called the Bayes rate fallacy. Even if the false alarm rate is very low, as long as it is not zero, then the Bayesian detection rate is still low, even if the Bayes rate is also very low. For example, using the formula in the previous slide, if we plug in these numbers, meaning the detection rate is 100%, false alarm rate is 10 to the minus 5, and the Bayes rate is 2 times 10 to the minus 5, then the Bayesian detection rate is only 66%. In other words, one-third of the time, when the IDS produces an alert, there's no intrusion. If you look at these numbers more carefully, 100% detection rate is perfect. False alarm rate of 10 to the minus 5 is also great. This is not zero, but it's very, very low. So you may ask, is this low Bayes rate realistic? This is 2 times 10 to the minus 5. It depends on where do you measure the Bayes rate. For example, if you measure Bayes rate at the network packet level, meaning that the number of packets that contain intrusion activities, which can be hundreds or thousands, to the total number of packets in the network, which can be tens of hundreds of millions, then this Bayes rate can be quite realistic. So the Bayes rate fallacy says that as long as the false alarm rate is not zero, then when the IDS produces an alert, the probability that an intrusion has actually occurred is also low. So how do we address this problem? We can reduce the false alarm rate to be zero, or as much as possible. In fact, that's what the vendors of IDS have been trying to do. Or we can deploy the IDS to the appropriate layer so that at that layer, the Bayes rate is sufficiently high. Modern-day IDS use a hierarchical architecture to achieve this. We can also use multiple independent models. This is similar to medical diagnosis, where multiple tests are used to reduce the overall false positive rate and increase the Bayesian detection rate.